In the Philippines, we have this conflict long time ago, before 9/11 happened and everything here in America. We have this rebellion before against the national government, the Muslim rebellion. It was really a rebellion to establish a national identity and the right to self-determination. So along the way, we have both sides, the government, the Muslims, at the Moro. We call that Moro rebellion during that time. So both sides have developed these prejudices against each other and things like that. And today, like I was just telling them, I think last year there was this feature in the national dailies. It was headlined. It was a picture of our president, President Aquino, and receiving a woman wearing a niqab, the niqab, yeah. And the caption read, "Security threat." So that was really hurtful. But what was very important was that not all the Muslims reacted, because with the advent of the social media, the Facebook and the Twitter and everything, there was a backlash against the national daily putting that caption. I think midday, because the daily goes out early in the morning, so I think midday, they reprinted the entire page and changed that caption. Unfortunately, that woman was my aunt. And she was there meeting the president because her son was appointed the regional speaker of our region, the autonomous region in Muslim Mindanao. So she was there as part of her son's pride. So she was wearing that. And then the media captioned that, "Security threat." So it's really hurtful. But and in some place, especially, I'm living in Davao City now. It's a predominantly non-Muslim community. We have subdivisions, not only in Davao, but I think in the entire Philippines. We have subdivisions who would refuse Muslims to buy houses or properties in their subdivisions. So this there are discriminations happening because of the negative stereotype, the negative perception brought about by media, by what's happening around the world that is perceived to be in the name of Islam and everything. So it's really difficult, but we have what we've been doing in our work is that we have to be always proactive in countering that negative perception.